Everybody, thank you so much for coming out to see us today. My name is Randy Calistri-Yeh. I play the cello. This is Millie Calistri-Yeh. She plays the violin and she gets the applause. This is Adrienne Calistri-Yeh. She plays the clarinet and the electric guitar and the electric bass. And we are here for the 15th annual Little Gazebo Concert. We've got, thank you, 15 years in a row. We've got plenty of great music for you today. We've got snacks and drinks just behind the hedge over there. Help yourselves. In addition to being the 15th Little Gazebo Concert, this is also the very last Little Gazebo Concert. We are moving to Connecticut, and I'm sure there are still many concerts in our future. But our new house does not have a little gazebo. So whatever we're going to be doing, it's not going to be a little gazebo concert. So this is indeed the end of an era. I apologize. I've got a bit longer than usual for my introductory talking here. There's a bunch of stuff I want to tell you and share with you. So I hope you'll indulge me for a few minutes. We promise we will get back to the music. This whole thing started when we moved to Florham Park in the winter of 2006, and we did not do a summer concert that first year, but the next year, in 2008, we did our very first Little Gazebo concert. There were 10 people in the audience, and we played mainly classical music. I do remember that Adrienne and I did a piano duet with the Australian Wombat March. Not classical, but it was still a lot of fun. And every year after that, it's gotten a little bit bigger. The audience has gotten bigger. We hit 75 people in 2018 in our backyard. The musical instrument collection has gotten bigger. Collectively, we have played 15 different instruments in these concerts. And the musical variety has gotten bigger. We have performed 120 different songs for you over the years. I've arranged most of them myself, specifically for our little group up here and for you, our favorite audience out there. Millie and I are classically trained musicians, and it wasn't until we started playing the Little Gazebo concerts that we really started broadening our musical horizons. We've done Broadway show tunes, we've done rock concerts, we've done K-pop songs, all sorts of crazy stuff. And it's because this is such a casual, informal setting with people that we know and like, that we can take some risks in playing music and trying stuff we haven't tried before that we never would have done on a concert stage. And so we thank you for that opportunity. why do we do this? Why do we do these concerts? We like playing music. We like performing. But we like connecting with people through our music. And that takes players and it takes listeners. And we've been very thankful and very honored to have such a loyal following over the years. Some of you have been to almost every single one of our concerts. Some of you we've met for the very first time here in our backyard at a Gazebo concert. And I'm sure we will build up a great audience in Connecticut, but it's going to be many years before we get anything approaching what we've had here in Florham Park, and we're very appreciative to all of you. We usually have a theme for our Little Gazebo concerts. We've done Broadway, we did a Beatles concert, we did music about Asia, we did greatest hits of the 1970s. This year, we just didn't have time. We're packing, we're selling one house, buying another. Adrienne's been in Greece for the last month, and she just flew back Friday night. Boy, are her arms tired. And we're putting this concert together on one rehearsal. So we're just pulling some of our favorite stuff from earlier concerts. So if you hear something that you've heard before, it's because you've been to one of our concerts before. That first piece was Be Our Guest from the Disney show Beauty and the Beast. And that's been our opening signature song since 2010. We added that to our third Little Gazebo concert, and we like the way it sounds, we like the way it feels, and we just like the whole idea that you are our guests here, and we're here to entertain you. Next up, more Disney music. This is from the animated movie Mulan. The recent live-action movie killed all of the music, so we're going back to the original. And we're going to do a medley of three songs from Mulan. I'll Make a Man Out of You, Reflection, and Honor to Us All. How's the sound out there? Doing okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So next up, one of our favorite songs from one of my favorite movies. The song is Scott Joplin's The Entertainer, and the movie is The Sting with Paul Newman and Robert Redford. Marvin Hamlisch was in charge of the music for this show, and George Roy Hill was the director. And Marvin Hamlisch read through the script and said, I know just the thing to make this movie really come alive. You should use ragtime music by Scott Joplin. And George Roy Hill, in addition to being a director, happens to be a music major from Yale University. He was a piano performance major. And he said, you can't put ragtime music in my movie. This movie takes place in the 1930s. Nobody was listening to ragtime music in the 30s. They had all moved on to jazz. And Marvin Hamlisch said, I know that, and you know that, but not a single person watching this movie is going to know that. You've got all of these con artists and all this action running around. Ragtime is perfect for it. And he did an absolutely wonderful orchestral arrangement of these piano pieces. And the feature piece was The Entertainer. So we're going to be doing our little trio version of The Entertainer.
Thank you.
Music from another movie next. This is James Cameron's Titanic. James Cameron had been fascinated with both the ship and the shipwreck of the Titanic for many, many years. And when they discovered the wreck, the location of it, Richard Ballard found it in 1985, and James Cameron personally went down in the submarine to view the shipwreck. And in the movie, when you see what look like the stage shots of the wreck under the ocean, that's actual live, not live, it's actual footage that he had taken while he was on the submarine and then got spliced into the movie. James Horner is the person that did the music for this movie. We're going to be doing Never an Absolution, Take Her to See Mr. Murdoch, and of course, My Heart Will Go On. The nice thing about playing string instruments, if you're in elementary school, you're guaranteed to have four notes in tune because your teacher has tuned your instrument for you. If you're a little more advanced than that, you're pretty much guaranteed to have four notes out of tune if you're playing outside because the temperature and the humidity keep changing and we keep retuning. Thank you. Music next, not from just any Broadway show, but from the Broadway show. This is Andrew Lloyd Webber's Phantom. It is the longest running show by far on Broadway, in Broadway history. At the time that COVID came and shut down Broadway, Phantom had been running for 13,370 consecutive performances without a break. It is unlikely that record will be broken in our lifetime. We are going to be doing All I Ask of You from Phantom.
Thank you.
We've been living here in New Jersey for the last 16 and a half years, I think. But I was actually born in upstate New York, born and raised there. Adrienne was born in New York and lived there until she was six. Millie spent many of her formative years in New York. And so we wanted to put a New York song on the program. Couldn't make up our mind, so we're putting two New York songs on the program. Adrienne and I are going to do a duet with Billy Joel's New York State of Mind. I'm taking a Greyhound on the Hudson River line. I'm in a New York state of mind. Billy Joel was actually sitting in a Greyhound bus on the Hudson River line when he came up with those lyrics. He was writing from true life. And after that, we're going to do Frank Sinatra's theme from New York, New York. Frank Sinatra did not write that song. John Kander wrote it. And he didn't even write it for Frank Sinatra. He wrote it for Liza Minnelli. But the definitive recording is, and always will be, Frank Sinatra's recording. So, two songs about New York from two people who were born in New York. Another duet. This is with Millie and me. This is a tango from Argentina called Por Una Cabeza. It was written by Carlos Gardel in 1935. And the tango is something that is uniquely Argentinian. It came into being in the 1890s in the rough port cities of Argentina, and there's really no other time and no other place that it could have developed, because you had this unique combination of European sailors bringing German waltzes and Czech polkas together. You have Hispanic people bringing Cuban habaneras. You have African slaves that are familiar with candombe and other African rhythms. And they all combined to form this new style of music called the tango. This particular tango may be familiar to many of you, even if you don't know the name, because it was featured in many movies, most famously in Scent of a Woman with Al Pacino, and most infamously in True Lies, where Arnold Schwarzenegger attempts to dance the tango with Jamie Lee Curtis. It's not pretty. This is Por Una Cabeza.
Thank you.
All right, Adrienne is switching over to guitar, and our next piece is one of the great hits from the summer of 67. This is Van Morrison's Brown Eyed Girl. It's sort of the definitive song of summer, and you can think about kicking back on the beach, down the shore, and you with the 50,000 other New Jersey people that are heading down the shore, and you get your 5 square feet of sand, but you're in a good mood and you're relaxed and you've got your rum and life is good. This is Brown Eyed Girl, Van Morrison. Next, one of our many Beatles covers. We did almost an entire concert of Beatles once. And this is the John Lennon 1964 hit, I Feel Fine. And it has a very interesting place in rock music history. John Lennon had set his guitar down and Paul McCartney had his bass plugged into the amp, and John leaned his guitar up against the amp. And Paul got ready to play the first opening note, which is just an A on the bass. And there was this huge squeal that came out of the amp. And John said, hey, that's pretty cool. Let's do that again. And that was the first time that you, one of the first times that you had electric feedback as part of a song, a part of a popular song. And that, as a complete accident, changed how you do the various types of effects that are in rock music today. It all happened because John got lazy and put his guitar down. This is I Feel Fine. I don't think any of us have gotten our clothespins to work today. Luckily, it's not very windy. We're going to do a song from Turkey. The song's name is Uskudar. It's sometimes called Katabim, depending on where you're from. And Uskudar is a neighborhood in Istanbul, the capital of Turkey. And Istanbul is a very interesting city. It sits right on the border between Europe and Asia. And there's a bridge in the middle of the city. And if you walk across that bridge, you have walked from one continent to another. And Istanbul has been part of the Silk Road trading path for millennia. You've got all the Europeans heading east to get spices. You've got all the Asians heading west to get whatever they need to get. I don't know, something. And beer, they were getting beer. And they meet in the middle, and you get all of these exchanges of ideas and cultures and everything else. And Every country in Central Europe has their own version of this song. They're all called by different names. They all have different lyrics. Sometimes it's a love song. Sometimes it's a military march. But it's always the same melody. And you know the phrase, all roads lead to Rome. That they were not talking about Rome in Italy, where the Pope lives. They were talking about the seat of the Holy Roman Empire, which at the time was in Istanbul. And all roads lead there because sooner or later, you're eventually going to hit the Silk Road, because all roads end up at the Silk Road. So this is Uskudar. We have some music by the great German classical composer Johannes Brahms. Brahms is most known for writing his four marvelous symphonies, a whole lot of choral music, but he was a pretty good piano player too. And in 1869, he was on a tour of Hungary, a concert tour of Hungary, playing mainly his own piano music. And in the evenings, as composers often do, he would wander the streets with his ears open, listening for new musical sounds and ideas that he could incorporate into a new composition. And Brahms discovered that he really liked Hungarian music. It had this real gypsy feel to it that you just didn't hear in German music of the day. And so when he got back home, he sat down and wrote a set of 21 Hungarian dances for piano. Of those 21 Hungarian dances, only three are original compositions by Brahms. The other 18, well, let's just say that he borrowed them from other Hungarian composers, some of whom were still alive at the time and not very happy that Brahms had come in and stolen their music. The one we're going to play for you today, the Brahms Hungarian Dance No. 5, should really be called the Béla Kaler Hungarian Dance No. 1, because Kaler is the guy that wrote the tune. Going back to Broadway for one of those very rare Broadway operas. There have been thousands of Broadway musicals, very few Broadway operas. What's the difference, I hear you ask? I will tell you. A Broadway musical is basically a play. There's a plot, there's a storyline, there are actors on stage, they're talking back and forth, and every now and then, for no particular reason, they just burst into song and sing something. An opera, everything is sung. There's not a single spoken word in there. Every single word has a melody to it. And this particular Broadway opera is George Gershwin's Porgy and Bess. It's a jazz opera that he wrote in 1935. And one of the big hits from this opera, two of the big hits from this opera, one is Bess, You Is My Woman Now. And the other really big one is Summertime. He liked it so much that he put it in the opera four times. And it is, if not on the calendar, at least in the gorgeous weather we're having today, it is summertime, it is wonderful, and we're happy to be out here, and hopefully you're happy to be out there, so we'd like to entertain you with this next number. Thank you all very, very much. It's been a great 15 years playing for you. This is bringing us to an end of the very last Little Gazebo concert. And we're happy that you could come today and that you could share our last concert with us. We're going to end this concert, as we end all of our concerts, with America the Beautiful. And please stick around afterwards, visit, chat with us, tell us what you're up to. We can tell you about our new place in Connecticut. And Adrienne can tell you all about the wonders of Greece and the future wonders of Michigan. And there are probably still snacks and drinks back there, and we don't want to eat them, and we don't want to move them, so hopefully you'll take care of that for us. America the Beautiful.